Hello, my name is Michael Litz, and I work in the Qlik QDI support group. We often get asked if Replicate can handle moving data from multiple source databases into a single target database. The simple answer is yes, Replicate can handle this type of configuration. I'd like to demonstrate how to configure Replicate tasks to handle this type of many-to-one replication. For example, imagine you have multiple separate customer contact databases across many regions of the country. You want to bring all the separate data into a single target database for reporting. There are three key concepts to this configuration. First, each instance of the customer database has to have the same table structure. Second, there is no guarantee that their primary key values will be unique across the databases. Third, in order to make this work correctly, the target database tables will need to have unique primary keys, which we will accomplish using a table transformation. In my example today, I have two source databases, Region 1 and Region 2. Each source database needs its own replicate task in order to move the data into the target, a database called Region All. Let's go have a look in SQL Server Management Studio and check out the databases. Okay, here we are in SQL Server Management Studio, and we're going to look at our two source databases, Region 1 and Region 2. Very simple databases for my example. I just have a single table customer in each, and the customer table has the exact same identical structure. Two fields, primary key, cus key, and a name. Same thing is true for region 2. Now the interesting thing is if I select from region 1, you'll see that I have three records with customer key 1, 2, and 3. Mike, Amy, and Ted. When I select from region 2, you see I have the same customer key, 123, with different customer names. That's to be expected. These are in different regions, different parts of the country. So this could cause a problem if these two tables end up as a single table in the target, because we'd have conflicting primary keys. And we're going to solve that problem when we get into Replicate by doing a table level transformation. We're going to add a region code field, and we're going to add that field into the primary key, thereby giving us a two-part primary key on the target, made up of region code and customer key. That will take care of any conflicts we might have with non-unique key values from the different source databases. And the one last thing I'll do while I'm here is I'll make a database for our target. So I'm going to create a new database, and I'm going to call it Region All. And that's all I have to do. I don't have to put any tables in here. The replicate tasks are going to create the tables for me automatically. So at this point, I think we're set with SQL Server. So let's now go over and take a look at the replicate tasks and how we would configure them. Okay, now we're in the replicate GUI, and we're going to look at how you configure the tasks. First thing I'm going to take a look at is managing the endpoint connections. We need to have a source connection to the Region 1 database. We need a second connection to the Region 2 database, and we need a single connection to the Region All database, the target. I'm going to have two tasks, Region 1 and Region 2, and I'll go to the Region 1 to Region All tasks first, and I need to add my endpoints. So now that I've got Region 1 as my source and Region All as my target, I'll come over and do table selection. I'm going to search, find my customer table, and I've added it in to my task. Once I've done that, I'm going to go to the table settings, and this is where we do that all-important table level transformation, where I'm going to add a column. I'm going to call this column region code, and I'm going to make it part of the primary key by just clicking out here. I'll say OK to that. I'm going to go over to region 2 and do the same thing. Region 2 to all, I'm going to put my source and my target endpoint. I'm going to go in, select my tables, customer table. I'm going to say OK to that. Now I'm going to go in and do my transformation. I'm going to add the exact same name column, region code, and I'll click over here to make it part of the primary key. So that's one of the important key concepts, is to go into the table, do a transformation, and modify the table, at least as far as the target's concerned. You're not touching the source. And we've added region code as a field to the cus key field that was already there for a two-part primary key. Now, we do have to set a default value. So whereas this is region 2 to region all, I'll set my region code to 2. I'm going to say OK to that. I'm going to come back to the region 1 to region all. I'm going to go into my table settings. I'm going to look at that transformation I created. Here's my two-part key, and I'm going to set a value to this region code, 1. So how is this significant? If you remember in the source database, I had identical primary keys. I had 123 in region 1 and 123 in region 2. What we've just did with those transformations is we've told Replicate that there's a two-part key and it's consisting of the field region code and CUSKEY. So now in the target, we'll have 1, 1, 1, 2, and 1-3 for region 1 records, and we'll have 2-1, 2-2, and 2-3 for region 2 records. This way there'll be no conflict in the target. Okay, next thing I need to do in designer mode, I've got to go over, and this is very important, on the full load, the default on a task is to do a drop and create table. And you don't want to do this because it's fine with a single replicate task, because if you were to reload, you could drop everything and you wouldn't mind because it's all coming from a single source. Where we have multiple sources, we've got to tell replicate to do nothing, just load the data. And obviously if there is no table out there, replicate will create it on the first run. But the significant part is when we run the second task or the third or the fourth or the fifth task, it won't alter the structure, it won't drop, it will not truncate records that are already there. And that's pretty important. Otherwise, you lose everything you got from your previous regions while you're loading up your additional regions. So I'm going to do the same thing with the region 2. Once again, its default is drop and create. I'm going to tell it to do nothing. And I'll save region 1. I'll save region 2, and at this point we're ready to run, so I'll reload target on region 1. And that went quick, because as you remember we only had 3 rows, but we've completed region 1 full load, and it's now in change processing mode waiting for updates or inserts and deletes. Now I'll do the same reload of the target for region 2, and this has just completed its full load from the region 2 source database. So at this point, and it's now in change processing mode waiting for updates, inserts, and deletes from the source. So at this point, pretty simple configuration. Key concept is to have a unique primary key on the target where the source may not, and we accomplish that by doing a transformation and adding a field region code, which we then hard coded to a particular region. So I'm going to leave these tasks running, and at this point it's going to make sense to go back to SQL Server and have a look at our database. Okay, here we are back in SQL Server Management Studio, and we're going to take a look at the newly created and populated RegionAlm database. You can see we did get our customer table down here. I'm going to right-click it and select top 100 rows, and you'll see that we have got CUSKEY 1, name Mike, region code 1, 2, 3, and we have our 3 records from region 2. These two pieces make up our primary key up here, and that's why we can do updates and we don't have to worry about any conflicts. So what I'm going to do now is go back into region 1 and I'm going to do an insert of number 4, Steve, and then I think I'll change Mike to be uppercase. And I'm going to make a couple of changes in region 2. I'll put in 5 and I'll make Dana uppercase. So there's an example of an insert and an update. And let's go back out to our target RegionAlm customer database and let's take a look at what we have out there now. So you can see that in region code 1 we have our original Mike is now uppercase, and the same thing in region code 2, the record Dana is now uppercase. We've also got our newly inserted records from region 1, I inserted Steve, and region 2 I inserted Bill. So that's a very quick and short demonstration of how to create a many-to-one task environment and a couple of the key concepts to keep in mind and how to configure that task. The number one thing being to have that transformation, making a unique primary key on the target. And the second most important thing is to set the task to do nothing, because when you run that second task, you don't want to overwrite or drop or truncate any of the records that have already been loaded from running the first task. Thank you very much. I'm glad you were able to enjoy this video.